Hi there, welcome to the AEC Bar. I'm here with my colleague Paul Walker up in the Sheffield office. Paul, who's actually my first boss from back in the Navisworks days.
It's been a while.
Paul's a product manager. He looks after BIM 360 Glue and has been, you know, with the BIM 360 and Navisworks team for quite a while. Hi.
Hello.
Hi. And really, we're here to talk about one of the questions I know I get asked quite a lot. And really, it's what's the difference between BIM 360 Glue and Navisworks? Why would I use one or the other? So, Paul, I want to ask you, what's your thoughts on that?
Yeah, well, if we if you think about like kind of the early days, going back quite a long time ago now, like kind of the traditional method for teams working and collaborating using Navisworks was typically you would have like a BIM manager working for the general contractor, let's say, or the main contractor, and then all your various supply trades kind of providing data, and they would send their models in through some kind of FTP site or something, and it would be up to that kind of the BIM manager working for the main contractor to kind of aggregate everything together, create one of these kind of a federated model, run Clash Detective in Navisworks, find all the problems, spend loads of time creating views and kind of filtering all of that through, and then everyone would get together in a big room meeting kind of once a week, once a fortnight, and then start to look through the issues, kind of decide who's going to resolve each issue, and then they would all kind of share a file, all go back to their separate offices and go dark for a couple of weeks whilst they hopefully get on with work, but no one ever knowing. And that kind of happening, then you'd get back together, models resent, and that process would continue and see what progress or not has been happening. How that's kind of been evolving with Glue means that you can, rather than having all that responsibility on one person, then Glue is providing more of a collaborative platform to provide really the ability for people to start self-checking or spell-checking, it's been referred to as, their models before they submit it to the main contractor. So again, earlier days, kind of people who were getting a bit more advanced would start to get expertise within house, within each of the subcontractors, and they would learn to use Navisworks themselves. So they would use that and do a bit of self-checking. But you still need to be quite a power user to be able to use Navisworks in that way. What Glue provides is a much simpler interface. It's stripped down, so it's a lower, a shorter kind of learning curve to be able to pick that up. And so to be able to do the kind of self-check and self-analysis of finding your clashes, resolving them kind of iteratively throughout the week or the fortnight, and being able to more regularly post updates so people can see what's going on. Mm-hmm. That also gives them the ability, or the other teams, the ability to kind of have more regular drops of the information so that they can then be checking as they go along. Yeah. So rather than having that one big bang every kind of every end of every week or every fortnight, you're kind of doing it more incrementally on a daily or hourly basis kind of thing.
Yeah, and I think, you know, from what I see, you tend to see a lot of people who spend a lot of the time trying to work out how to resolve thousands of clashes and filtering and sorting and grouping and sending out reports, and it's quite a manual process. And when you think of the cost of each individual clash, really, you know, what we should be looking to do is, rather than trying to create better reporting, is actually get that number down. So by essentially using Navisworks as a proofreading tool, mm-hmm. Of which others are available as well, mm-hmm. And being able to use Glue as kind of a spell checking tool, mm-hmm. but them two working together, it really helps kind of speed up that process. One of the customers we've been working with recently, a company called Mace, they've been looking at their process, and they compared for the BIM manager, whose job doesn't really change, they still use Navisworks on a day-to-day basis to do those proofreads of the files. They're using BIM 360 Glue as a way of getting all the files together, allowing each member of the design team to spell check their work, mm-hmm. but their role is massively reduced. They've managed to take a process that's taking several hours once a week into something that's taking 10-15 minutes. So it's massively helping them, and it's also helping improve the quality of the models as you go along. So, Paul, one of the other things that, you know, we talk about is what other benefits glue helps bring, and it's not just the design process, is it? You can take it further on.
Yeah, exactly. So obviously glue is part of a broader BIM 360 kind of solution, and so as well as just being that kind of pre-construction and design development kind of interaction, you've also got the connection into the field. So being able to provide these kind of approved models that can be then pushed out into BIM 360 field, that then takes the model-based data as well as kind of 2D sheets and so on out into the field where people can actually access that information. They can then start capturing status information about materials and components that have been delivered and installed and so on. And all of that data is tracked and kind of filters all the way back through. So not just available in field, you can then see that in glue, in any of the glue clients. You can see it in Navisworks, and it also pushes back into like Revit, for example.
Yeah, which can be really useful, not just for progress tracking, but also for commissioning. One of the earlier videos we produced, we talked a little bit about the UK mandates and how you deliver COVID deliverables. BIM 360 Field is becoming a really important part for contractors in the UK of how they deliver that. So working together with a portfolio of BIM 360 products and Navisworks is really allowing people to kind of do a lot more with the tools we've got. So thank you for that. And if you've got any questions, you know, feel free to email us on v.aec.bar@autodesk.com, and we'll speak to you soon. Thank you.
Cheers.